to allow communication across clusters, we need to have like a common root CA used to generate the certificates of the different workloads. By default, when you deploy the Istio control plane on the cluster, it's going to auto-generate a CA certificate it's going to use to sign the local the certificates for the local workloads. And the second Istio in the other cluster is going to do the same. So these CA certificates have nothing to do one with another. And that prevents the workloads to be able to communicate together across clusters. So you need to have this common root CA or intermediate CA used to generate the intermediate CA of each cluster that is then going to be used to generate the workload certificates. You can do that manually by creating all these certificates and distributing these certificates in the different clusters by creating the different secrets. But in Gloo Mesh, we have the ability to automate this process using multiple different architecture and also providing the ability to rotate these certificates. So here, what we're going to do first is to look at what we have right now. So if I am on cluster one, if I send a request from the review service to the rating service, then I can take a look at the certificates that is going to be presented by the target service. And you can see here, you know, the certificate of the workload, and this is the CA certificates that has been auto-generated for this cluster. And now if I run the same command on the second cluster, so reviews on the second cluster is going to rating on the second cluster, I will see that the certificates are different, like the CA certificates. You see the one of cluster one, like with RVRUL, and the one cluster two has nothing to do. Right? That will prevent communication between the clusters. So what we do here is that we create this root trust policy, and we say we want this root CA to be generated, auto-generated, and we want to restart the pods automatically so that they start to use the new certificates. It's just like to avoid waiting for these pods to request a new certificate to the control plane. Obviously, in production, you are not going to enable this auto restart, and you are not going to use a generated certificate. You are going to provide this certificate as a secret, or we have multiple different integration with different cloud providers to get like the certificates in a different way. So I'm creating this policy here. And if I go to the first clusters, I'll see that there is a new secret that will be that's already created in reality, that's called CA certs. So as soon as the Istio control plane see that there is a CA cert secret, it's going to use this secret instead of the Istio CA secret. There are options that you can set in Istio so that it gets that new secret used even without having to restart Istio-D, but in our case, we don't really care about it because we set this variable to restart automatically all the services. So they are just like, you see all of those different services are being restarted just right now. And if I go back here, so it's a little bit like explaining the way it works, right? So basically, there is a CSR that is created by the agents to request the intermediate certificate for the local cluster, and then it's going to store this intermediate CA as a secret. And now that we have this, you can have a look at this CA secret in more details. But what we want to see is that if I now initiate the same request that I initiated at the beginning, sending a request from the review service to the ratings, I can see now that I have like more certificates. I have the workload certificate. I have this intermediate certificate that is shown twice. You see like one LC, and oh, I mean it's the intermediate certificate is shown once, but the root certificate is shown twice, right? And you see here is like 80U And if I look at the second cluster, so again sending the request from review service to the rating service on the other cluster, I will see the same ATU, right? So now they are using different intermediate certificates, but they are issued from the same root CS, so this cross-cluster communication will be possible. And what you can do is that you can also get this certificate stored in a file, and then you know, decrypting these certificates, and you'll see some information about the workload itself. So basically this certificate is the one presented by the rating service that will allow the rating service to prove its identity to the other services, and we use this PFID. And you can see here in the PFID we have the cluster name, the namespace here, and the service account. Okay, so that gives like a unique identity for each service account globally. And we have one service that is called InMesh that is not part of any workspace, so it's not going to be restarted automatically. That's why I'm going to restart it now.